credit.
It's old fashioned. Chop you an animal sales day. Y'all come get credit.
No, sir.
Nor anybody else.
River City! River City next! Hush for the merchandise. Hush for the fun goods. Cash for the hard goods. Cash for the cotton goods. Hush for the soft goods. Cash for the fancy goods. Cash for the noggins and the piggins and the firkins. Cash for the hogshead, cask and mini joint. Cash for the cracker and the pickles and the fly paper.
Look, what are you talking? What are you talking? What are you talking? What are you talking? What are you talking?
You can talk.
Gentlemen, you intrigue me.
give Iowa a try.
Don't believe I got your name.
Don't believe I dropped it.
Create a desperate need for a boys' band, you remember.
What's something new around here? What can I use?
Nothing. Except the billiard parlor just put in a new pool table.
What? What, they never had a pool before?
No, only billiards.
That'll do it. See you later, Mars, and don't forget. Music teacher.
Music teacher.
Excuse me, sir, do you run this shop?
Yep.
Lady, you're closing your eyes to a situation that you don't wish to acknowledge. You are not aware of the caliber of disaster indicated by the presence of a pool table in your community.
Well, you got trouble.
Right here is a troll, right here is a sure and you declare certainly I am proud to say I'm always mighty proud to say. I can certainly the hours I spend with you and my hand are golden. I to cultivate poor sense and a cool head and a keen eye. For a three-round billiard shot, but just as I say, it takes judgment, great maturity, and score a ball in a game. I say that any fool can take and shove a ball in a pocket, and I call that sloth the first big step on the road to the depths of dead Brene. I say first, then spill wine from a teaspoon, then beer from a bottle, and the next thing you know, your son is playing for money in a pinchback suit, and listening to some big out-of-town jazz for he'll tell about a horse race game. Some trotting race, no one race, but they sit down right on a horse. I'd like to see some stuck-up jockey boy sitting on Dan Patch. Men blood boil, I should say. Now, friends, let me tell you what I mean. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 parts on the table. Parties part the difference between a gentleman and a bum. With a capital B, that rounds with P, that stands for boom. And all week long, you're in the city, you could be frittering away to see you. And we'll be frittering. Frittering away at any time, sometime. Short time too. Get the ball in the pocket. Never mind getting dandelions corn. The spring roll patch and the beefsteak pounded. Never mind pumping any water to your parents' pot with a sister empty on a Saturday night. That's trouble. It's got lots and lots of trouble. I'm thinking of the kids in the Knickerbocker shirt tail yummies. Picking in the pool hall when you're out of sporty out of trouble. Folks, right here in the city. Trouble with a capital T and that rhymes with P and that stands for pool. Now I know all the folks of the right kind of parents. Conversation goes on for a loaf around that hall. They'll try it out me. Try it out Cubans. Try it out Taylor Mays. My cigarette beans. And brag and all about how they're come from the telltale breath with sense. One fine night, they meet the pool hall, headed for the dance in the armory. Libertine men, scarlet women, and ragtime. Shameless music that'll grab your son, your daughter, the arm of a gentle and the instinct. That's staring. Friends, the idle brain is the devil's playground. Trouble. Knickerbockers below the knee. Is there a nicotine stain on his index finger? A dime novel hidden in the corner. Is he starting to memorize jokes from Captain Billy's whiz bag? Are certain words creeping into his conversation? Words like sweat and suits your old man? If so, my friends, we got trouble.
Trouble!
Oh yes, we got trouble! We do not think it's trouble!
Look out!
Every night I say goodnight to one evening star. You have to do it the very second you see see it too, or it doesn't count. Good night, my Winthrop. Good night. Sleep tight.
Oh, no, dear, Dolly, don't cry. You have lots of time.
If not Winthrop, it will be someone else.
Never! I'll end up an old maid like you!
I'm sorry, Miss Marion. Can I play my crosshand piece?
Yes, may
I play it? You have nothing to say goodnight to on the evening star.
I know, dear. For the time being, just say goodnight, my someone. You can put the name in when the right someone comes along.
All right, it's better than nothing.
Yes, it is. Now you can play your costume.
Now I may play my costume.
You lady McKechnie Shin will take a leading part. fireworks spectacle, last days of Pompeii, will take place providing rain stops by 9:30. It'll be out in Madison Picnic Park in the far meadow, across the creek from the test house.
How could it be raining? Didn't the Gazette predict fair?
Sure it is, that's why we all prepare for a storm.
Well, Gazette's accurate most of the time, you know it, JC.
You won't get very far in the baking business being accurate most of the time.
Now, just a minute, let's have order here. Order, order.
The number 7's late again.
I make her up to be early.
Oh, she's late all right.
She is right on time. What is the matter with your watch?
Will you members of the school board stop bickering?
All the world, that I says is...
Never mind! Four score.
There's a pool table in town.
Yeah, that's why, her.
Now, just a minute, let me...
Is it a pool table?
Will you allow me to get along with the exercises?
We don't want any more exercises till we get this pool table mat settled.
Let's protect our children.
Yeah!
Resist sinning corruption.
Yeah!
Like that devil and keep our young boys pure.
Yeah!
Attention, please. I can deal with this trouble, friends, with the weight of my hand, this very hand. Please observe me, if you will. I'm Professor Harold Hill, and I'm here to organize the River City Boys' Band. Don't think my friends are in any pool table ever hoped to compete with a gold trombone. Remember, my friends, what a handful of trumpet players did to the famous, fabled walls of Jericho. Oh, billiard parlor walls come tumbling down. Hear the thunder of rolling drums, the shimmer of trumpets, da-da-da-da! And you'll feel something akin to the electric thrill I once enjoyed when Gilmore, Liberati, Pat Conway, the great creator, W.C. Handy, and John Philip Sousa, all came to the river this dark day. 76 strong bones led the paper rain. Thank you.
That man! He's a spellbinder! I haven't seen either people get so excited since the night. Rain God and Rain Yulu was laying on the mat for 3.5 hours without moving a muscle! Never mind. I want that man's breath. Who grabbed that book of tea on the floor? This is a shame!
Thanks, Professor. I have to make an example out of him. Great leader, you know. When he does, the gang does.
Greyhawk, let me go!
You wild kid, ya! Hanging around my oldest girl, you wild kid, ya! His father is one of them day laborers south of town. Tagging down Main Street after my oldest girl last Sunday.
We wasn't either tagging.
Don't you contradict me!
We're just walking together. Greyhawk!
You watch your phraseology! I know what you're doing! My little Gracie's seen ya! Now, stay away from my daughter, or you'll hear from me till who laid the rails! Hill, I'll talk to you Monday morning about this band thing over at City Hall, 10 o'clock sharp. Then, I want that spellbinder's credentials.
Come on, Tommy.
Oh, Constable. I'll be responsible for Boyd.
You don't know this kid. He's tough. He's got his gang waiting outside.
Oh, I'll be careful. Tommy, I'd like to talk to you about the band.
Gee, Professor, that's just for the little kids.
Oh, I'm not talking about playing the band. You're mechanically minded, aren't you? Ever do anything with perpetual motion?
Oh, I nearly have a couple of times.
You did?
Well, you're my man. Are you aware that nobody has ever invented a musicola for a marching piccolo player? No place to, you know, to hang the music.
Wait, huh? Wonder I can get some wire from.
Oh, well, look in your cellar. That's where people keep wire. Oh, and Tommy.
Yes, sir?
And now, Constable, I will show you how to break up a gang. Oh, young lady. Oh, miss. Excuse me. What's your name?
Zanita. I had no idea you was beckoning to me. You guys.
Do you know Tommy Gilles?
Well,
Tommy, this is Zanita. Escort the young lady home.
Only, except that I'm not going home. I've got to go to the library. Oh, ye gods.
Then escort the young lady home by way of the library. Oh. By way of the candy kitchen.
Yes, sir. Do I have to?
Oh, you have to.
Yes, sir.
Wow, Professor. You're a pretty brilliant fellow. Made a couple mistakes, though.
Oh. Mm-hmm,
yeah. The mayor happens to own the building and the new pool table.
Oh. Well, what was my other mistake?
Oh, that's Anita girl. She's the mayor's oldest daughter.
Just a minute, Professor Hill. We'd like to have your credentials. We're at the school board.
Academic certificates. Nothing of the kind.
We need letters and papers.
Make a political mob.
Wait a minute. What am I hearing? You say.
Ice cream. But I don't sing, young man. If that's
all right, talk then.
Down here.
Ice cream.
Professor Hill.
Professor of what? At what college do they give a degree for a
about that. I'm a conservatory man myself. Gary, Indiana. Gold medal class, Vault 5.
Even should that happen to be true, does that give you the right to follow me around wherever I go? Another thing, Mr. Hill. I am not as easily mesmerized or hoodwinked as some people in this town. And I think it only fair to warn you that I have a shelf full of reference books in there, which may very well give me some interesting information about you.
Good day.
Oh, hey, Greg.
Oh, hey, Marcellus. Don't call me Greg.
So, how'd you make out with the music teacher?
Scrumptious. Ate out of my hand the minute I tipped my hat.
Oh, she did? Boy, did you cut a swath tonight. For a minute, even I thought you knew something about leading a band. Just like when you used to imitate that band concert fellow back in Joplin.
Oh, yeah. Kid stuff. I'm in rare form these days, son. Just you keep your eye on me for the next 4 weeks.
4 weeks? It used to only take 10 days for the instruments to arrive.
Well, it still does. But it takes 4 weeks for the uniforms.
Oh, no, Greg, you haven't had uniforms.
Uniforms and instruction books.
Instruction books? But you can't pass yourself off as a music professor. I mean, not for any 4 weeks.
For myself.
But you don't know one note from another.
I have developed a revolutionary new method called the Think System, where you don't bother with notes.
But in 4 weeks, the people will want to hear the music. They'll have to lead a band.
But when the uniforms arrive, they forget everything else. At least enough time for me to collect and leave. This is a refined operation, son. And I've got it timed right down to the last wave, the last hand, on the last brakeman's hand, on the last train out of town. And now, Mr. Washburn, if you'll excuse me.
Gonna line yourself up a little canoodling, huh?
Well.
Say, I could fix her up with Ethel's sister. Lovely girl. Teaches Sunday school.
No wide-eyed, eager, wholesome, innocent Sunday school teacher for me. That kind of girl spins webs no spider ever. Now listen, boy. A girl who trades on all that purity merely wants to trade her independence for her security. The only affirmative she required was to march in down the line of the world and glorious queen, Christine Goddess. No, sir, for no time ever do I pray for alignment. That right now. I snore, I hiss. How can ignorance be compared to bliss? I spark and I fizz. For the lady who knows what time it is, I cheer and I rave. I'm too late to say the saddle lies a girl for me. Expression of line and movement.
set the chairmanship of the ladies' auxiliary for classic dance. Mustn't she, ladies?
Oh, yes,
every move you make, it, Mrs. Shin, bespeaks ill sort.
Ill sort.
Will you? Will you? Oh, say yes, Mrs. Shin.
Oh, you lazy, but hate me, Shin! Oh, well, that's it. Dancing room!
Then you accept?
Oh, yes, indeed, I would just like to say
that. Thank you. And now, of course, the young lady who plays the piano, Marion Peru. After all, she is the librarian.
Madison Gymnasium, Madison Picnic Park, Madison Hospital. That's Miser Madison?
Exactly! Who do you think he was anyway?
I should say, show off. Probably gave the town the library too, didn't he?
That's just it. When he died, he left the library building to the city.
But he left to all the books too!
She was seen going and coming from his place.
Oh yes, that woman made great trouble.
Madam Librarian. get some supper? I'll try a couple for myself.
Bye, Professor.
Thank you, Tommy.
Oh, just a minute here. Are you soliciting? You haven't got a license.
No, Mayor, should I? I collect doorbells. This particular specimen has an unusual tone.
Flattery will not avail you. Soliciting is statutory in this county. Malfeasance without a permit. Why haven't you been down to City Hall with your references?
Just missed you. Mr. Mayor, your head! Oh, no.
What?
That spread with the little finger. Why, it's hereditary.
Oh, it is? What does that mean?
It means that your son's little finger is perfectly situated to operate the spit valve on a B-flat flugelhorn.
Is that good?
Good! Well, it means that America has at last produced an artist who can flugel the minute waltz in 50 seconds.
How can I get one of those horns?
Well, sign here, Mr. Mayor. That will be $17 in court fee.
Yes, sir. Just think I could have missed on this one. I haven't got any son. You once priceless, flew by night. You once priceless, you. Be down at City Hall with your buyout papers at 3 o'clock.
You mean this afternoon?
Couldn't make myself any plainer if I was a Quaker on his day off.
Mrs. Peru, are you aware that you have the facial characteristics of a coronet virtuoso? Well, if your son has that same firm chin and those splendid cheekbones, by George. Not that he could ever be really great, you understand, but...
Oh, and in the name of St. Bridget?
Why not? Well, you see, all the really great cornet players were Irish. O'Clock, O'Mendez, O'Klein...
Oh, but Professor, you're Irish.
No. No, really. That clinches it. Sign here, Mrs. Peru. Your son was born to play the cornet.
You say so.
That will be $7 of earnest money. Nothing more due until the first installment, payable at the opening event practice. Ah, thank you. And, of course, only the boys' measurements for his band uniform.
His uniform?
Hello, son. Why, certainly, his uniform. And there won't be a penny due till delivery, which gives him 4 weeks to enjoy, to anticipate, and to imagine, and no cost whatsoever. Never allow the demands of tomorrow to interfere with the pleasures and excitement of today.
Would it have a
stripe? Why, certainly, my boy, a wide red stripe on each side. What do you think of that?
Excuse me, Professor. We can't get him to say 3 words a day, even to us. And if you get him to play in that band of yours, well, you'll have to take my clothes on with. But if anyone can do it, I'll let you can. At the crowd, I think it was a hard train to play quite so often. Shamrock ran top of the air, Terrence, I'll let you sing it out. Some Terrence, what's wrong with mine?
Oh, Gary and Deanna.
What?
Gary. Indiana. In fact, Gary Conservatory was my alma mater.
Oh, was she now?
Oh, yes.
Oh, how did
Gold Medal Plasma Prize. How do you do, Miss Peru?
How do you do, Mr. Hill?
Of course. Peru, I thought the name sounded familiar. You know, I tried to see you since the other night, but...
He was put with us in the end.
We're not interested, Mama.
Oh, but Marion, he can have his father's musical gift.
He does have my job.
Your husband, he's old. I'd like to have a talk with him. I'm sure that we can...
Do you charge to everyone's home like this, prying into personal affairs? We're not interested, Marion.
Well, that's one for and one against. Why not let the boy's father decide?
The boy's father is dead. Anything else?
Oh. I'm sorry. But that's all the more reason why your brother should have something.
My brother is a 10-year-old problem child who can't understand why his father was taken away. Would you care to explain it to him? He's been brooding about it for 2 years.
As to your musical tricks, why don't you go into business with some nice carnival man who sells gold-painted watches and glass diamond rings?
Miss Peru, I hardly think that's fair. I get the feeling she likes the idea. A little cautious, perhaps, but I admire that plan. Just keep me alive and I'll be back later in the week.
Professor, about the boy's measurements. I made all the clothes myself. Almost ready?
Whatever you're ready.
Okay. Sleeve 21. Waist 18. Crotch 14.
Fine, thank you. That's all I need. Now I really must get back to the hotel.
Professor, you'll have to excuse Mary. She's not...
Please, ready. Don't worry about the thing. Who should put it at heart? She's as lovely as herself. Good day to you, whatever you do.
Thank you.
footprint.
Well, now isn't this just what I said? Last time the lumber yard, this time the footbridge. What'll be next? The black hole of Calcutta? Ye gods.
I only want to show you my invention.
What invention?
My music stand for marching piccolo player. It's still the cover monitor law. See, when you hold tight enough to the music stand, you lose circulation and can't wiggle your fingers. Meanwhile, you could go blind.
Is that the first thing that I said or not?
Yes, George.
Yes, the very first thing, for I only came with a horse. Get that spell by the credentials, I said. Morning of July 4th, 1912. And now look, my wife is off dancing and Indian all hours and sending the home with the school board and sitting up treating down alley instead of tending to city matters. My oldest girl is booting along with some wild kid. And my business has fallen off so far, I can't even drive to Allen Street.
Mayor Shin, I found something very interesting in this book about Professor Hill's alma mater.
His who?
His university.
Now I know all about that. In fact, that's the only thing I can ever get out of my Gary Conservatory, class of all time.
But if you'll just take some time to read a little bit about the conservatory, I don't think you'll have to look much further. It's on page...
Papa! Papa! The Wells Fargo wagon is coming up from the depot!
Wells Fargo wagon? The likely story at this hour of the day, not...
Street, I wish I knew what it was coming for.
It's a booby!
Now, I'm gonna kiss him. Very first thing is usually a hussy. I don't wanna wait till the second time out is anything but hussy. But I'm gonna wait till the third time around. Head in the clouds, green on the ground. She's the girl he's glad he's found. She needs her shoe.
That girl is hard to get.
Shabooby.
But you can't win her yet.
Come on, girl, why don't you just bring some good things?
Why? You got it in front of your back?
Do what?
Never mind. Anita's scared of you, but I'm not. I should think maybe how your own daughter scared of you. Great Hulk!
I'm going to warn you once more. If I ever catch you touching my daughter again, I'll, by God, horsewhip you till hell won't happen again.
Oh, now, George, don't.
Not one poop out of you, madam. Yes. Now get out! Get out of this public building!
Well, I got as much right in a public building as anybody.
Right? How do you get me right around here? Aiding and abetting the swindling activities of that spellbinding symbol salesman. You know what I see written all over you? Reform school. Now get out! Get out, you wild kid!
Papa, please!
Tommy,
but it's capitalists like you that make love in the marketplace! Ye gods!
You watch your phraseology, young woman. Go home.
Yes, sir.
You lady.
No,
you pay me your dance. I'll handle Anita, taken up with wild kids from the wrong side of town.
Oh, you understand? If I could just make you understand.
Well, you can't. And by the way, thanks for nothing. I read that book you gave me from cover to cover for a whole week now and didn't find a thing.
Mr. Mayor, if you please, I'm really...
Oh, settle your ass. As soon as I get these privacies off of my daughter. Yes.
Right. But in the meantime, I want you to know that I am vouching for Tommy Jules. That boy has the confidence of every kid in town. And you'll be standing in line waiting to shake his hand by the time our band plays its first concert.
By the time your band plays its first concert, the individual members will have to foregather in wheelchairs on account of the broken leg they'll get from tripping over their beards. Oh, I'll tell you something, my fine young feather, never mind. Oliver, J.C., Ewart, Holden, I want that man's references, and I want it tonight. Don't let him out of your sight. He's slipping your neck. A Mississippi sturgeon.
Do you mean you want us to get his credentials?
Papers or get him in jail! Couldn't make myself any clearer if I was a button hook in the well water!
Professor Hill, I think Mayor Shin has behaved abominably, and I think it was wonderful if you come to Tommy's defense.
That was nothing.
Yes, it was.
Well, a man can't dodge an issue where it's kind of a little personal risk is involved. What did the poet say? The coward dies 1,000 deaths, and a brave man only 500? Of course, the mayor already was putting the head on account of his pool table. I suppose a recommendation from a musical authority such as yourself could help, but I couldn't think of asking you to do a thing like that.
Why, Mr. Hill?
What, Hill?
I'd be glad to. I just wish I was a little more informed. I've been meaning to talk to you about Winthrop's cornet.
Oh, his cornet? Mother of Pearl Keys.
I'm sure it's fine, but we never touch it. All the first week or so, I made a few experimental blats, I guess you'd say.
Yes. Yes, blats.
And he sings the minuet in G almost constantly.
La di da di da di da di da la di da.
But he never touches the cornet.
Well, you see.
He says you told him it wasn't necessary.
Well,
he tells me about some things.
Miss Marion, the think system is a revolutionary concept, I'll admit. As was Galileo's conception of the heavens, Columbus's conception of the egg, the globe, and Bach's conception of a well-tempered platform. Now, I cannot discuss these things in public, but if you allow me to call my name, we may call.
Why, any night this week. Pick a little talk, we'll
take a little talk. Jimmy, talk about Miss Peru! Please join our Dental Stars Committee!
We're so tired of that. She'll take a little talk.
Golden shimmer.
Sorry, Professor, but we got our orders.
We've all been deputized.
Yes, congratulations. You know, I've been by to try to give you fellows my credentials a few times this week, but every time you seem to get off the subject somehow. Now, I have just what you need back in my hotel room, so take me a second.
I'm afraid we'll have to come with you.
Yes. Well, let me see if I have my key. What's this? A testimonial from Madame Reed, the only female best-selling player ever to appear on the Red Path Circuit. Her stage name, of course. Actually, she was from Moline. Lyda Rose Brightonbush.
Could I see that for a minute?
Oh, you'll never forget the name. Lyda Rose. Sing us the old song. Lyda Rose, I'm home again, Rose.
To get the sun back in the sky. Lyda Rose, I'm home again, Rose. About a thousand kisses shy. Ding dong ding, I can hear the chapel bell chime. Ding dong ding, at the least suggestion, now about the question. Lyda Rose, I'm home again, Rose, without a sweetheart to my name. Lyda Rose, now everyone knows that I'm hoping you're the same. So here's my love song, not fancy or fine. Lyda Rose, oh, won't you be my Lyda Rose, oh, Lyda Rose, oh, Lyda Rose.
Thank you. Either one of you turn the last to me, girly girl!
Don't
Think system? I've been by your house to try to explain it to you in time or two, but every time there always seem to be people around. Mostly ladies, I thought.
Oh, Mrs. Squires and several ladies.
Oh, I'm glad. Wouldn't want anybody beating my time.
You wouldn't?
Why, no, now? Well, I see it's evidently not the convenient time. I'll see you at the social later.
Professor Hill, is it true that you had 100... What I'm trying to say is...
Yes.
Is it true that you... developed a think system?
What? A think system! What? Yes, it's really quite simple. Simple as whistling. Nobody ever has to show you how to use your lips when whistling. You simply think a tune up here, and it comes out clearly here. Try this for yourself before you ask any questions.
Oh, I have to take your word.
Could we sit down?
Are all music teachers as dense as I am?
All music teachers? Well,
I dare say you'd be dozens, even 100.
Well,
have they all been as fascinated as I have with the think system?
Some more and some less. One young lady I met developed the same system before I got to her town. She showed me a few refinements.
I see.
I said something wrong.
Please don't let me keep you, Professor Hill. You must have many more important things to do than explain the think system to me. And I must be very dull company for a man of your experience.
Say, where'd you get an idea like that?
One hears rumors of traveling salesmen.
Well, Miss Peru, you mustn't believe everything you hear. After all, one even hears rumors about librarians.
I suppose you're referring to Uncle Maddie.
Uncle Maddie?
Mr. Madison, my father's best friend. No matter what they say, he left me in a sure job so that Mother Winthrop and I would have some security. Surely you don't
see. Of course not, but you see, that's exactly what I'm saying. And why do you think people start those rumors?
Narrow-mindedness. Jealousy mostly, I guess.
Exactly. And it's mostly jealousy that starts rumors about traveling salesmen. What have you heard?
Nothing about you personally, just generally.
What have you heard generally?
But of course it stands to reason that disappointment and jealousy can often lead to... Take you, for instance, having your attentions to... customers, and well, teachers might be misinterpreted, mightn't they? I mean, no, honestly, mightn't they?
Why?
And so you say it's another salesman or somebody we're jealous. Well, they could be downright wise, couldn't they?
What could?
Rumors and things.
Why, of course!
And so it just goes to prove you shouldn't believe everything you hear. I mean, if you discuss things.
Miss Marion, I would be delighted to discuss anything in the world with you. But couldn't we do it sitting down? You sit and just bend at all.
We could sit on the porch steps.
We could also sit on the large hollow log over the footbridge.
Oh, I couldn't think of it. I've never been to the footbridge with a man in my life.
Just to talk.
I've got to know something sociable.
Then meet me there in 15 minutes.
I just can't. Please, some other time. Tomorrow, maybe.
My dear little librarian, I'll open up tomorrow, and you'll find that you collected nothing but a lot of empty yesterdays. Now, I don't know about you, but I want to make it today worth remembering.
So would I.
Footbridge. 15 minutes.
supposed to know? I got timing neglected. I told him to go home and practice over the lumber yard, but I'm just trying to keep all the kids together.
Okay, Marsh. What time's the break, though?
9:40 from the junction. It's not even 8:30 yet. Listen, you want a turtle world around here and get yourself caught up in a bunny trap, you go ahead.
Don't worry, Marsh. I'll meet you at the hotel in plenty of time. Miss Marion, you're late.
But you said 15 minutes.
Well, actually, I'd say that you're about 26 years late. Took you all this time to get to the bookery for the fellow?
To tell you the truth, it was almost longer. Halfway here, I nearly turned back. I suppose I'm not the first to find it easier to think clearly when not under the spell of your salesmanship.
Now, Miss Marion, certainly you don't think I've been trying to sell you anything.
Oh, no. Me something. That's why I decided to come.
I don't recall giving anything.
Yes, you have. You do. That's why I came. I'm glad. Please don't be afraid that I expect too much more. I can't expect traveling salesmen to stay put. I know there have been many ports of call, and there will be many more. But that's no reason for me not to be grateful. What you will have left behind for me.
Resigning without my commission.
But Greg, you can't get anywhere out here on a football. bridge?
There's a place over in Madison Park that makes this footbridge look like the old lady's home. Now beat it! Go get the ring! Never a peaceful moment in the music business. Now then, where are
you? You were about to tell me what I don't know about you?
Yes! Well, we don't have to go into that just now, do we?
No, we don't. Or ever, for that matter. The librarian hasn't felt much like doing research lately. But she did plenty when you first came here.
Oh. About what?
About Professor Harold Hill here at the Conservatory, gold medal class, bought 5. Harold, there wasn't any Gary Conservatory in on 5.
Why, there certainly
was. Because the town wasn't even built until on 6. Let's see the search for.
You knew? All the time?
Since July 7th, 3 days after you came. I tore this page out of the Indiana Journal. It was originally intended to use against you, but now I give it to you with all my heart.
But if you knew, then why didn't you?
Thank you.
talk to you for a minute.
I won't listen. You won't tell the truth anyway.
Hey, what so?
Would not.
What so? Tell you anything you want to know.
Can you lead a band?
No.
Are you a big liar?
Yes.
Are you a dirty, rotten crook?
Yes!
Oh, leave me go, you big liar!
Hey, what's the matter? You wanted the truth, didn't you? Now, I'm bigger than you, and you're going to stand there and get it all. So you might as well quit wiggling. Winthrop, there are two things that you're entitled to know. One, I think you're a great kid. I have from the first. That's why I wanted you to be a part of the band. So you'd quit moping around feeling sorry for yourself.
What band?
I always think there's a band.
Well, what's the other thing I'm entitled to know?
Well, actually, now that you mention it, the other thing isn't really any of your business.
I wish you'd never come to River City!
No, you don't, Winthrop.
Sister, you believe him?
I believe everything he ever said.
When he promised us.
I know what he promised us. And it all happened just like he said it would. The lights and the flags and the colors and the symbols.
Where was all that?
In the way every kid in this town walked around here all summer and looked and acted. Especially you. And the parents too, whose mama wish you'd never come to River City.
Well, you do, don't you?
No, Winthrop. No, no, Harold, please.
Go on, Professor, hurry up.
I can't go, Winthrop.
Why not?
For the first time in my life,
have you forgotten the
the clear understanding and warranty that your children would be taught to play in a band. Well, where's the band?
Thank you.